Hey guys, and welcome back to FTB Skyblock Infinity Expert Mode. I think I got it right. And it is a welcome back because this is the first episode since the hiatus of the series due to the server switching around stuff. The world is now on my own personal computer, so it is now officially a single player series. It's no longer multiplayer. There will be no seeing other people, which is something I had hoped for, but didn't end up happening. But we will continue nonetheless. So, I actually wanted to start this episode off with a little bit of news, just due to the fact that this episode is about 2 weeks delayed, 2 or 3 weeks delayed. It's all a bit of a mess right now, whether it's 2 or 3. Anyway, I intended the Thursday right after the teaser trailer came out to do the first episode of this. However, as you saw, I instead put up a vlog. Well, some of you probably saw that I put up a vlog explaining that things were getting pretty stressful and I didn't know whether I could keep the schedule. Following that vlog, I ended up coming down with a throat cold, which meant that I couldn't record anyway, which really put a dampener on things. And then after that, my second monitor died because I have a 2-monitor setup. So I'd been sorting that out, and yesterday the monitor finally arrived and it ended up having a fault in it right from the box. It had a white flickering bar at the bottom, and that can only get worse. So I've had to package that up again, so I'm back down to 1 monitor. And also, at some point, I think I've slipped a disc in my back. So I probably have a herniated disc in my back right now, so moving around can be pretty painful right now. Although I am comfortably in my chair, so we should be able to do the episode just fine. And the final calamity to happen was, you may have noticed that this episode is a day later than it should be, because I tried to record this episode yesterday, and because I was mucking around with the monitor yesterday, at some point I unhooked the mixer's power. So I was basically just talking to myself for 40 minutes while I did this over here. Speaking of this over here, this is what we're working on. We're starting on the storage warehouse for the base. But I think before we do any more with this, I need to explain what has happened between the final episode of the first half of the series and now. So I built this room. As I was moving things over, I realized I was going to need more room. As you can see in here, I've kind of just dumped all the chests and things using the dolly in corners and wherever I can, really, waiting for the storage warehouse to be built. And then as for the machines, I've put them in here and hooked them up just so that I can use them for the time being. There will actually be a proper machine area at some point, and it probably won't be this room, but that's where things are at. And as for how much has been removed of the old platforms, I had left this intact the last time I was actually managed to get on the server, with the intention of just leaving this running to let these fill up as much as they could before the server turned off or the areas unloaded. Because of course now we don't have chunk loaders, and I don't have this on a server, so this is only going to run whenever I'm on, which makes Skyblock a lot harder actually, because a lot of the processes that you do in Skyblock, preferably you leave them overnight on a server running in a loaded chunk so that you can acquire lots of nice materials, but we won't have that. I do have my rendering my small little rendering computer, which I could potentially hook up to do, to just have a server on all the time. But I haven't done that yet. It may be something I look at in the future. And of course the mob tower is still intact. So that's all that's left, along with the animals. I knew there was something, I knew I went over here for something and I just never said it. So let's get to the storage now that I have all that out of the way. Right, where did we get to? We got to building the shell of the walls. Obviously, the lead part of the roof has not been put on yet. We just have the wooden area. This building is actually going to be taller than the others because it is a large warehouse. We're going to have on this side, as you can see, I've laid it out already. We're going to have shelving units, basically, of either chests or drawers or what have you, all hooked up to a logistics pipe system. That's why they are two across, because it's whatever you're storing the items in and the logistics pipe, right? And then they're going to be roughly that tall. I don't know how big that is. Where's my tape measure? 6 high by 7 wide and 2 across. So we got 10 of those. Lots of storage space. And then this side here I've intentionally left open because we might like to have some non-standard storage at some point, because not everything will fit into this nice neat row system that we're going to have, in which case they take up this side of the warehouse. So, being that we are at this point, the best place to start, I guess, would be to make a logistics controller. Is that what it's called? I'm so rusty on logistics pipes, guys, to the point where I will end up just derping around a lot trying to get it working. But I kind of want to derp around and teach myself it again. But if it gets to a really bad point, what I'll do is I'll go off to a wiki and take a look at what I'm missing. So fear not. Anyway, I need to get this jetpack fuel back and I'll be right with you. Okay, so my jet fuel is full. So I guess the first place to start is always the logistics power junction, huh? So we're going to need a couple of redstone. And 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Do I have 11? I do. I will move that all over to compacting drawers at some point, guys. Don't worry. It'll be done once this all works out. So this is the power junction. Whoops, took one too many iron. Very surprised that the power junction had such a cheap recipe actually for Skyblock, but there it goes, we have the power junction. So the next thing obviously is our basic logistics pipes, which are more expensive. We need our diamond pipe, 2, and standard glass somewhere in one of these chests is normal glass. There it is. Great. I'm going to need 2. Since you get more than one pipe per recipe. Here's our diamond. And our cobble. And redstone torch. Now the hardest part of this recipe is the golden chipset. Oh, that was meant to be a diamond chipset. All right, that's fine. I also need some quartz. Let's just take 64 quartz and put that in the alloy smelter. Alloys, please. And golden chipset. Do I actually have any lying about? Because that would be handy dandy. might actually do, but if I don't, they're easy enough to make. Some golden redstone. Which we have plenty of both nowadays. No. Alright, that's fine. Why don't we just make a stack of those, because we're gonna need them in the future with logistics pipes. So, in you go. Do not make those, make these. Thank you. Let's all turn on. Excuse me, I just had a bit of a coughing fit. So this is stepping down to medium voltage, and I think the reason I did that is because I only had MV wire connectors and I couldn't be bothered making HV wire connectors. That's the only reason. But I probably should make them HV, because then it can use this fully, this power supply, to its best capacity. And we're going to need more diesel generators in the future, but we're going to have to get our storage up and running before we even consider a machine room, because that machine room is where our steel production is going to go. And we certainly don't have enough steel for another one of these babies. So I'll be back once I have enough for some logistics pipes. Alright, I think I have everything to get us started at least. I don't have the things that I'm going to need to plug into the chassis, but we'll deal with that when it gets there. I just want to get some layout done. We need to get power over to the warehouse. So we're probably going to go from this power line here, since it makes the most sense. I'm actually going to take down this, of all things. I won't take that bit off just yet. I will at some point, probably off camera, replace that with a balloon. So that it's got a balloon hanging over the platform. But in order to get this lined up, doesn't really... Well, that placed below me, didn't it? You. I want a balloon on top. No, not balloon plus three. I only want balloon plus... Well, I just want balloon, actually. Well, to be fair, maybe I want balloon plus one. That plus one, by the way, is how high it gets placed when you place it. So if I want it right in front of me. So I think it places at your feet. So yeah. Here we go. I think that's right. Or have you gone one higher? I think you went one higher, didn't you? You can check. Yeah. Yeah, you're definitely higher. Even on this angle, I can see it's higher. That's annoying. Can I get... No. What about now? No. Can we get far enough? There we go. Okay. I mean, the system works. It's just hard to tell in Skyblock because you have no frame of reference in front of you for where you are compared to everything else. Okay, so... Let's just make sure I got that right. No, I don't want absolute either. There we go. It's good. Okay. Relay. HV wire coil. And I don't really mind if there's like... If it's uneven where the balloons are, the balloons don't have to be evenly spaced in a grid or anything. You just have to get the power to where it needs to go. Preferably at maximum length. Which that is not. Oh gosh. Give balloons. Place balloon. There we go. Of course, just make sure. One, that is correct. This might be too far out though. Don't know how long the HV cables can go before they hit their limit. No, that's okay. Right, so we can probably put one like right here. Well, not right there. Right there will be where the power goes in. But I want to put one adjacent. No. Parallel? No. Adjacent. Yes, it is adjacent. Good one, Brayden. Oh, every time. Every time. At least I got it right that time. Give me that. Relay. Cable. I don't think you're lined up properly, though. No. You're one out. Dang it, Bobby. Alright. It's alright. We can manage. I don't mind if I lose the piece of HV wire to the... I didn't even lose it anyway. Cable. Balloon get. Okay, now you're centered. Nice. So, here's the thing though, right? Where do we want the power to actually come in here? Because what I might end up doing actually is bringing the power underneath and then having the power junction more towards the middle. And I'm not sure. Let's give it a go. Let's give it a go. So you. And I'm wondering whether I actually need another relay or if I can go straight to a connector. The connector obviously has to sit on the power junction itself. Relays only transfer power between each other, not to actual blocks. So where's the power junction for the logistics pipes gonna go? I'd like to have it visible, so I'm gonna probably put it in the floor. Doesn't need to be visible, but I would like it to be visible. So you can go there. You're not centered, good one me. Good thing my magnet's on. Not that that's very expensive, but it's the principle of the matter. Okay, so I should be able to put a connector directly on that now. We should start seeing power. Oop. And the answer is yes. We have a functional logistics power junction. Right. I've already derped up, guys. You see, in the process of sticking this power junction right in the middle of the floor, I have unwittingly, because of the way that the power is connected to it, stopped myself from having available positions to put a logistics pipe coming off it, because of course a logistics pipe needs to make contact with it in order to get the power. So give me that. Me this. So I have to think more functional about this rather than aesthetically. I mean, why don't I just put it right under here, right? Because we absolutely 100% know that logistics pipes are going to go here. And it's still kind of centered with the room, and it doesn't really matter because it is just the power junction. And as long as I can see it and put the mouse pointer over it to get information from it, I will know in the end what's happening. So it would kind of go like this, right? That's only there temporarily, just to show. Let's hook you back up then. What a waste of power. Boop. Alright. So, we now technically have a functional logistics system. Or it will be functional once there's actually something hooked up to it. Here's one thing I wanted to make, though, before I went any further. You, logistics HUD glasses. We're going to need some diamond chipsets. Oh, that's going to be fun. I don't think my golden chipsets are done yet anyway. I wanted to do 64, and I also started doing iron chipsets as well. So, that's a thing. We'll turn those off. We'll grab two diamonds. This will take a while, unfortunately. What? How do I not have any more diamonds? I absolutely have more diamond. I know where they'll be. Right. Diamonds are the least of my worries these days. Right, 1, 2. And I'm messing with my balance of redstone by doing this, but I don't mind. Make me 2 diamond chipsets. I'll be back once those are done. Alright guys, derp number 1 has been found. I need a soldering station to make the glasses. No big deal. But I'm ready to make the lenses. I'm also making a lot more diamond chipsets because every single part of this requires a diamond chipset. It's 5 in total. Plus another 1 because we're going to need a quick sort module for our input chest. So, we need wood. Just somewhere around here in this mess of boxes. Can't wait until I don't have to do this anymore. I know I had some wood around here. There it is. 1, 2, 3, 4. Crafting table. I think it's 6 and a piece of redstone. Yes. Yes. 6 iron, that is. Okay. And crafting table. We have our soldering station. Good. Now it just needs to be connected up to power. I mean, here will do, maybe? No. Maybe this has to be hooked up to a logistics pipe? I actually have no idea. It's been a long time since I played with logistics pipes, and I don't think I've played with it since it had a soldering station. Yes, it is exactly what you do. You hook it up to a logistics pipe. Very strange. Alright. That's fine. Let's go get my stuff. Give me that. And 2 of those. And 14 redstone. And before I make that mistake, 2 iron. So, iron, redstone, chips, and glass. Make lenses. Go. Go, go, go. Go, 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 go. Why you no go? I mean, this slot doesn't actually exist in... maybe it needs a lever? Let's see about that. We need a lever. Where would I keep levers? Why don't I just make a lever? Save some time. Right. No, what did I do? I put it up there. How did I do that? And go. No? I don't get it. I obviously have the recipe correct because you have the lens over there. This has a burning icon, which makes me think it needs fuel. But you have power. I know you have power. Yes, I can hear you all screaming at the screen. All right, I'll go and take a look at what I need. Oh boy, that's annoying. Things I didn't know. All right. I guess for now. Actually, I didn't need to break that pipe. For now, you go here. Basic logistics pipe goes there. Now the network is powered. The mistake I made was the power needs to be provided by a basic logistics pipe, and it needs to be in the side of a logistics power junction, which I didn't realize. There we go. You are. Oh, I see. Could only. Couldn't stack in the solder thingy? Not sure. So I'm gonna find a better position for that power junction off camera, I think. How many diamond chipsets have we got in the meantime? That is the right amount. How about that? So I need six diamonds there and two there. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. Right. You and you and you and you. And I forgot to bring the iron. Of course I did. It was bound to happen. You all saw it coming. One, two, three, four, five, six. Why am I getting six iron? I don't know. One, two, three. I went back in time in my memory or something. There we go. One. No. It's very interesting. They stack in your inventory, but they don't stack in the soldering station. Now, were you like that, or were you like that? Or were you like that? Right. And then this and this and this and this. And I didn't bring enough iron because I'm a dip. Like, I knew I was gonna have to do that, and for some reason, I didn't think to grab the fourth bit of iron. Never mind. And now we have HUD glasses. That was a lot of work, but now we n hopefully never have to make them again. So this thing shows us everything we'll ever need to know about our network. As you can see, I've put my chassis down there and another chassis up here. And it even tells us how much we got stored in there, although this GUI is kind of covering that one. So I have some blank modules. Do we have a final diamond chipset yet? I would really like to show that off at some point. Where is our item sync? Quick sort. Two blue dye, two redstone. Wait, no, it's just two blue dye because we're using the diamond chipset method. So come with me, Lapis. You and you and you and you. And you. Here we go. So I don't know whether this is going to work straight off the bat. Because I think you're gonna need something, and we also don't have a chest there yet. Do I have my dolly on me somewhere? No. I have seen it in one of my chests though, somewhere. Oh gosh. Chest opening noise for days. You? No, you're not hiding it. Who's hiding it? Who's got my dolly? Right, I have things that are missing. I don't know where or how or why. I guess I did things between episodes and died or something and lost it forever. But when I tried to record the episode yesterday, I was missing the chisel, and the tape measure. So I'm obviously missing the dolly as well. I don't know where they are. Gosh. All right. I guess just a normal chest will do for testing. For testing. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Good. Normal chest. Right. Don't think this is going to work whatsoever, but it's worth a shot. Treated wood. Go somewhere. Do something. I mean, when I click you, you make a funny symbol. Do nothing. How do I interact with that? Shift right click. Yo, I want to get at the chassis inventory. Alright, well, I know what I'll need. I'll need a poly who's a what's it. Poly who's a what's it. That one. Polymorphic item sync. So we need a iron chipset. Got that. And orange dye is very easy. We just need some yellow and some red. I'm so glad I made those flowers. Dye is used a lot around here. Oh, I have orange. Never mind. Let me get out of my inventory. Run away from the electromagnet. Alright. So let's just go grab an iron chipset from over here. I actually made those iron chipsets to make logistics pipes easier. But that's fine, I'm gonna have 64 of them anyway. Polymorphic item sync. Great. So, the way these used to work in the old days, and hopefully they still work the same way, is you configure them, or you don't configure them rather. You just put the item you want to go in there, and then it will know to put items of the same type. Yes! It works! Hooray! Okay, so derping aside, enough of my memory was intact to get logistics pipes working to this point. So, next episode's going to be even more exciting as this whole area builds up, which will be super cool. Anyway, thank you all for watching, and I will see you next time. Bye-bye!